Let us now consider two examples of density matrices. The first example that we'll consider is a density matrix of a system arising from a process that generates a zero with probability half and a one with probability half. Again, we first take the state 0 and 1 and individually turn them into density matrices. So from 0, I'll get 0, 0. Which gives me 1, 0, 0, 0. And from 1, I have 0, 1, 0, 1, which gives me a matrix 0, 0, 0, 1. To compute the density matrix, we can compute the average of these two matrices. So half, 0, 0. Plus half, 1, 1. And this gives me half, 1, 0, 0, 0, plus half, 0, 0, 0, 1. So I have half times 1, 0, 0, 1, which is the identity matrix over 2. Let's now consider another example. Here, we don't start from the vectors themselves or the probabilities, but I will actually give you a density matrix. Because you may have been wondering if it's the case that from the density matrix, I can find out exactly again what the probabilities and vectors actually were. Of course, if I give you a matrix rule, you can compute its eigendecomposition, meaning that you decompose it into some eigenvalues, which I'll call pj. Remember that they're all positive, and sum to 1 because of the conditions of the density matrix. And eigenvectors. So the question is this decomposition unique? Let's actually go back to the example that we've just calculated. Namely, the matrix that I give you is the identity matrix over 2. Rho is a mixed state, and in fact, it is called the maximally mixed state because it is as mixed as it possibly could be. And we already saw in the last example that one way to obtain this density matrix was by a process that with probability half gives us 0 and with probability half gives us 1. The question is now, is this the only process that leads to the maximally mixed state? The answer to this turns out to be no. And one way to see this, note that any state is an eigenstate of the identity matrix. Another way to see this is to consider another process that with probability half prepares the plus state and with probability half prepares the minus state. Again, let's compute the resulting density matrix. We will start by computing the density matrix for these states individually. So plus is this, it's 1 over square root 2, 1, 1. So the density matrix for plus, so I have 1 over square root 2 times 1 over square root 2 is a half, 1, 1, 1, 1, which gives me a half, 1, 1, 1, 1. Let's do this for minus. 1 over square root 2, 0, minus 1, which is 1 over square root 2, 1, minus 1. So if I compute a density matrix from that, minus, again I have a prefactor a half, f1, minus 1, 1, minus 1. So what do I get? I have 1, minus 1, minus 1, 1. Now, if I compute the density matrix of this process, again by averaging, a half times a half, and I plug this in here directly, 1, 1, 1, 1, plus a half times what we got here, 1, minus 1, minus 1, 1. We have a quarter. So note that the terms with a minus 1 cancel against the terms with a 1, which gives me 2, 0, 0, 2. Which, if I take the quarter into account, again gives me the identity matrix over 2. We thus see that even though the density matrix is a very useful description, it does not contain all the information about how it was generated.